Hey everyone, in this video I'm going to do this statistics and probability problem. It says let x be a continuous random variable with the probability density function, and then we're given the PDF where f of x is equal to 3x squared between the values of 0 and 1 and 0 otherwise, and we're asked to find the median, the mean, and the variance of the probability distribution. So this is a video that's similar to one I did a couple months ago, and a couple months ago I did one where x was a discrete random variable, and we were given the PMF, or the probability mass function, which is the probability distribution for discrete variables. So this is sort of the continuous random variable version of that problem. So when you have a continuous random variable, you're given a PDF, and we're going to solve for the three parts of the question. So in the first part of the question, we're asked to find the median of the probability distribution. For continuous random variables, the median is going to be found with the following formula. So we're going to find the CDF, or the capital F of x, and we want the CDF at the value equal to 1/2. So when you have a PDF, that's going to be some function. And then basically when you find the cumulative distribution function, that's equivalent to taking the area under the curve. So this is saying that we want to find the point where we're finding basically half of the area. So that's going to be the point where the CDF is equal to 1/2. The formula for that is we want to find the cumulative distribution function, so that's going to exist from negative infinity to infinity of the PDF. So we're integrating over the PDF. The PDF is 3x squared dx. We want to find the value for 1/2. The CDF exists from negative infinity to infinity, and the PDF, the function, exists from 0 to 1. So in this case, we're going to go from negative infinity to some value m, and the m is what we're trying to solve for. So we need to integrate from negative infinity to some value m, the PDF, and that will give us the area equal to 1/2. In this case, because the PDF exists from 0 to 1, the lower bound, instead of being negative infinity, is going to be 0. Because anything less than 0, the PDF does not exist. The PDF is just 0. So that integral is going to be equal to 0 to m, 3x squared dx equal to 1/2. And then we just have to solve for the missing value m. So when we integrate that, that's going to give us 3x cubed over 3 from 0 to m has to be equal to 1/2. 3 over 3 is just going to be equal to 1. So we're just going to plug in m. So m cubed minus 0 to the 3 is just 0, is equal to 1/2. So that means m is going to be equal to 1/2 to the 1/3. And this is equal to approximately 0.794. So this is our final answer. So if we integrate up to the point 0.794, this will give us approximately half of the area under the curve. So that's the solution for A. For B, we want to find the expected value, or the mean, of the probability distribution. So we want to find the expected value. Anytime in general when we're finding the expected value of some function g of x, that's going to be equal to the integral from negative infinity to infinity of g of x times f of x, where f of x is the PDF. So in this case, we're just going to plug in what we're given. So for expected value of just x, that's going to be x times f of x dx. And we already know that the PDF in our case exists from 0 to 1. And I'm just going to plug in f of x here, which is 3x squared. So once we find this integral, this will give us the expected value, which is also equal to the mean of the probability distribution. This is equal to 0 to 1 integrating 3x squared dx. So it's going to be equal to 3x to the 4th over 4 from 0 to 1. And when we plug in 1 and 0, that's going to give us 3/4 minus 0. So the mean is equal to 3 over 4, which is also equal to 0.75. So we're done with part B. And then for part C, the final part, we want to find sigma squared is equal to the variance. So we want to find sigma squared of x, which is equal to the variance. To solve this, we're going to rewrite the variance equation using expectation functions. So the variance of x is equal to the expected value of x squared minus the expected value of x, and then this entire function is squared. So from part B, we have that the expected value of x is 3/4. So we can already plug this into the second part of this formula. It's going to be minus 3/4 squared. And then we only have to find the expected value of x squared. The expected value of x squared is going to use the general equation that we had before. So this is basically g of x. So our g of x is x squared. So that's going to be the expected value from negative infinity to infinity of x squared times the PDF. The PDF is 3x squared dx. Plugging in for where the values of the PDF exist, this is going to be from 0 to 1. And then I'm just going to simplify this. So x squared times x squared is equal to x to the fourth. So this is really finding the integral from 0 to 1 for 3x to the fourth. So when we solve for this integral, that's going to give us x to the fifth over 5 times 3 from 0 to 1. When we plug in 1 and 0, that's just going to give us 3 fifths minus 0 is equal to 3 fifths. So the expected value of x squared is 3 fifths. So now plugging into the variance equation, that's going to give us the expected value of x squared is 3 fifths minus the expected value of x, and then the entire thing squared is 3 fourths squared. That is approximately equal to 0.0375. So that is equal to the variance. 3 fourths is equal to the mean. 0.794 is equal to the median. And we are done with this problem.